Taking a look at this, the Marvel Legends Target exclusive, or US Target exclusive, Captain Marvel Starforce figure. It's actually not really Captain Marvel Starforce, it's Captain Marvel Starforce and Minerva, or Dr. Minerva if you've read some of the old comics, because you kind of get two figures in one. We'll take a look at the figures, the packaging, and the two options that you've got, as well as comparing the facial structures to the previous facial sculpture. Yeah, the sculpture to basically the two previous kind of Captain Marvels that we've had. So a pretty good figure overall, thanks to my good buddy for getting hold of this for me, because it's not yet been made available outside of the US, and it's just been really picked clean at many Targets throughout the US as well, so making it even doubly hard to get hold of. We've got some nice artwork on the side of the box. Again, the Captain Marvel logo at the bottom in nice shiny reflective material, and Captain Marvel's in the box. Again, her logo is up at the top of the box, and on the back we get a kind of weird picture of the actress, but doesn't really kind of fit the way they've morphed it into the figure. I don't quite know why. And then showing you the alternative head sculpt. There's a bit of text if you want to freeze frame. Really doesn't tell you a great deal in different languages. And the UPC, should you need it. I'll put a link in the description below, and you can go and pick it up from eBay, probably be the best source if you can't get it anywhere else. So this is a direct repaint of the previous Captain Marvel figure, and as you can see pretty much here, everything is generally the same. There are some slight tweaks for paint, obviously, but it's really the same figure. There's not a great deal of difference. Let me get the focus going here first of all. So yeah, pretty much everything is the same. The belt structure, the underlying sculpt is all over the same. It's just clearly different paint that seems to be used. No difference even in the boots, as you can see, the little grooves in the sculpture and the way they've been painted or not painted on one and the other, even down to the shoulder pads and the arms and the sides there. Everything appears to be absolutely identical. No difference. Hasbro does love a repaint, that's for sure. They have been nice though in giving us these two options for the figures, but there's a lot not quite right with this figure. So let's get a look at Minerva first, and then we'll go into Carol Danvers. The first thing you want to notice, certainly, is the blaster. This is not the blaster that Minerva uses in the movie. It's not even close. The scope is round when it's square. It's a completely different gun design. I suspect, I don't recall seeing this before, and if you have, let me know, but I suspect this is a weapon from another figure that is coming out somewhere down the line, or someone's blaster, and we're kind of getting it packed in here first. But it's not the blaster that Minerva uses, to the best of my knowledge, in the film. I have only seen it once on screen, but a good Google around and lots of different screenshots and up-close images, and not even close. So I don't quite know what's going on. And I don't see Captain Marvel with it either, so maybe I'm wrong. Again, go to see the movie, and we'll watch it on Blu-ray again hopefully soon, and get a chance to see whether that's weapon. But it's okay. It's got that kind of green Star Force colour going on through it, but it's kind of unusual, but it's just, yeah, I was kind of looking forward to that more chunky like blaster that we got in the movie, or the sniper rifle really that she had. What we also get here that's a little odd, these are painted in the Star Force green when they're not actually green in the movie at all. They're black. The little tips at the end are green, but they've just kind of went a bit nuts with the paint here and painted all of these, but those little pellets are not, they're not that colour. So, okay, not the biggest deal in the world, I guess. We do get the scarf, which is right. That's a removable piece there, and this kind of holster. So it all looks right. But then we get to the facial sculpt, and it's just not even... I don't know whether it's trying to be the comic version, or it's... I mean, it's clearly the movie outfit, but Gemma Chan does not have pink lips in the movie at all. This is green, this piece up here. This colour here, the kind of almost black green. For this, so this is kind of blue. She also has a braid on the side of her head, not shaved. So again, I'm kind of like, are they using a head sculpt here from something else they're going to do? They're not the first time they've done this. But probably the biggest and glaring issue here is Gemma Chan has really long hair. It's at least down to where my thumb is in the movie, and not this short hair. So I don't recall this being from something else, but it looks very likely that, again, Hasbro are using this for something else, some superhero heroine somewhere, because they just ain't Minerva. It's just not her. So a kind of weird way they've done this. But, you know, I'm just being nitpicky, but I'm pointing out because someone will if I don't. So that's pretty much the basics of the figure. She holds the blaster pretty well and got a nice kind of pose in the hand. But again, it's those little small things. Really nice getting this bandolier here, getting the little scarf at the back, which looks good. But hair, and even the hair is not blue in the movie at all. It's mostly black with a couple of curls that are blue. So very odd. Very odd where we're getting this from. It's a kind of hybrid comic slash whatever Hasbro wanted to do figure, really. It doesn't make any sense, but there you go. If you know more, please leave a comment and let us know. So that's Minerva. Let's look at a look at putting on Captain Marvel's gear, and then we'll do some comparison. So if we take that off and we pop on the Carol Danvers head, we've got a couple of options. First of all, we can put the masked head on if you want to. And it's the same as the previous Captain Marvel. The hair's nicely kind of weathered and done there. It's just this time, obviously, in the Star Force green. So you get a couple of looks for the figure. You can also put the Carol Danvers kind of regular head on. There we go. And, of course, swap out her blue Minerva hands for the Carol Danvers hands, which is a nice little extra in the box that they pack. Let me just pop that off and pop that on. We'll be good to go. So, we get a nice new-ish Carol Danvers head. Let me compare this to... Now, I've swapped the heads around in several of these Captain Marvel figures, but you can see slight differences in there. It's probably the same figure, but it seems like a little smirk in that Captain Marvel compared to that one. But they're all pretty much the same. Hair sculpt looks to be identical. Side profiles look to be identical. It's pretty much the same sculpt. Little differences of paint perhaps are added in there, but it's probably just the same face. So really not a great deal of difference. This does seem a little sharper, this one, than that one. We did get a previous other head as well. This was the kind of bomber jacket version with the kind of blowing hair there. And that's slightly different. Not my favourite one, but... still, we get an option. So again, it looks really like the actress. It's very close. The hair is probably more brown than I would have suggested. I would have thought it would be a bit more blonde. But there you go. That's what we got. So it's a nice swap out and difference to the figure. And again, you can get some pretty good poses. Exactly the same poseability as the previous figure. You've got a ball joint on the head. Pretty reasonable movement considering she's got hair there and it kind of locks into place. You've got a ball joint up at the top of these shoulders, a little bit limited with the shoulder pads, a single joint at the elbows, and you've got swivel wrists and back and forth. You've got an ab crunch, which is pretty good overall. Pegs up at the top of the thighs, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, no boot cut, but rocking ankles and peckles, pretty generous ones. So she's pretty good. The Star Force slash Minerva Captain Marvel is a pretty cool figure. Do like her. Again, we'll put a link in the description directly underneath to go and pick it up. Go get it. She's pretty good. Definitely recommend it. The fact that you get a couple of options, even if they're not quite accurate in any way, they're kind of good. Let us know what you think, and we'll see you for the next video coming up.